Girls, good morning. Welcome back to day 18 of the Advent Stories with Miss Chris. Now, if you were paying attention on day 17, I was wearing this t-shirt. Day 17, I forgot my book at home. I ran up to the church and filmed my day 17 video. And while I was at the church, I went ahead and filmed day 18. So today is really in the video, day 18, but I'm filming it on day 17. Confusing, right? Well, anyway, the main thing is that you get your day 18 story because we're getting real close to Christmas. We are down in single digits. It's getting real close. 1 week from today, Christmas will be here. But first, we've got to remember those stories that lead us up to the birth of Jesus. Now, yesterday we learned a story about David and Goliath, one of my favorite Bible stories of all time. Today is this another one of my great favorite stories. It's the story of Jonah. And I love Jonah because it was the very first story that Miss Chris taught when I became a children's pastor here at this church. So it's very special to me. Every time I read it, I think about those first little boys and girls that were in my ministry. But today, we're going to learn how the story of Jonah points us to Jesus, which we celebrate at Christmas. Jonah was a prophet, which means God gave Jonah messages to tell others. One day, God told Jonah to tell the people in Nineveh that they were evil and broken. But Jonah was refused. The people in Nineveh had done terrible things. Why should they get to hear God's message? Jonah knew God wanted to save them. Jonah got on a ship and went in the opposite direction. He tried to run away from God and his plan to rescue the Ninevites. God sent a storm with huge waves, a storm so big it almost broke the ship. Everyone on board cried to their gods for help. Jonah told the sailors what to do. The men called out to Jonah's God, then threw Jonah into the sea. The storm stopped immediately, and those sailors believed in the one true God. But God sent a great fish to rescue Jonah from the sea. The fish swallowed him whole. Jonah stayed in the belly of the fish for 3 days and 3 nights. He prayed to God, and God made the fish put Jonah back on dry land. In the Bible, it says he spat him out. Again, God told Jonah to go to Nineveh to say that in 40 days, Nineveh would be destroyed. This time, Jonah obeyed. He told the people God's message, and they believed God. They were very sad about their evil. The people of Nineveh called out to God, and he rescued them. That made Jonah angry. Jonah didn't want good things to happen to bad people. He didn't realize that he was bad too. He had also disobeyed God and done evil. But God showed Jonah that the grace of God was for everyone. God loves everyone and everything he has ever made. And he will rescue anyone who wants to be rescued, no matter how selfish or bad they are. So when you look at this picture, this big old fish and the man in the belly of the sinking into this ocean, doesn't look much like Christmas, but it reminds us that God sent a rescuer for me and for you, even though we had done those bad things. Christmas time, we can celebrate a Jesus who has come to save us all. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for Advent, and thank you for the stories of the Bible that remind us of why we need rescuing. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Have a great Saturday, and I will see you on Sunday for day 19 and here at the church for our annual adult Christmas cantata. It's amazing, and you're not going to want to miss it. No Sunday school tomorrow, but come for big church.